Hello, welcome back. This is Mega Nintendo Wolf collecting Howsy stuff, because Howsy stuff is good.
Pick a box! A content will help make you way. I butchered that.
Come on, open. I pick you. Got you, Pikachu? Oh, bastard. Nope, just a Fire Flower. To be honest, Fire Flowers are my least favourite Mario power-up. Not gonna bother with a slot machine because I fail at this. If I wanted, I could go for that Mushroom House, but it seems a little bit out. You know what? It's out of the way, so that means it's gonna be good, and I'm gonna cut until I get there. Okay, use our hammer that we earned before on that, and hopefully this will get us to...
Pick a box, it's content will help you on your journey and your way, and
anything good in here, please. Yes! Tanuki suit, I knew it! The power to get big suits and stuff. See you back at the castle. Okie doke, let's help the person inside. It's Donkey Kong Jr.?
Oh, it's terrible! The king has been transformed! Please find the magic wand so we can change him back!
But, as a monkey, if he still has his intelligence, even though monkeys are pretty intelligent, he would have a lot more capabilities to be in that, because he can swing, he can still write a pen, he would still have opposable thumbs. He's just a lot more hairy. So, yeah, no real problem there. Unless he really were vain and cared enough about looks, but it's a monkey, not too bad. Though I'm not too much of a fan of monkeys myself. But, I don't know, yeah, I just don't know what I'm saying anymore. Oh, that was a spinny thing. That would have helped us dodge fire, which the screen scrolling and not let me go faster than that. Come on, faster. And why does this make me kind of think of A Link to the Past, that bit of trumpet playing right there? Maybe it's because A Link to the Past does have quite a bit of trumpet playing. Mostly in the Dark World and the Storm song, which is in the Dark World, so... Oh, shoot 'em a blobs. Duck, because that will... But how is that not igniting my hat and ears? I'd love ears and a tail. If it was just wolf ears and a tail, if I couldn't be a wolf, if I could just have, like, wolf ears and a tail, I'd love it. Oh, close one. I mean, you could make, like, little cuts in your hat like Mario fucking hell. Like Mario does, and cut in your pants. Well, I say pants, that's an American word. Trousers. And you could have, like, a tail and ears. That would be, like, so awesome. You could hear better, and maybe your balance would be better, because I think that's what tails do. I mean, I've been told that they do that, but... Really, does a tail cause that much more stability in wolves and cats? Well, cats is kind of obvious because their tail is more movable, but does it really benefit wolves a lot more? I mean, would it be when they're jumping for their prey or something like that? Oh, is that a doorway? No, it isn't. I've played this game before, it's just not a long time, so yeah. And I won't make that jump, so I'll have to be on the other side. You pop thingy. I would have got hurt anyway. Hurley-oop! Am I over here? Yes, I am. I'm safe, and... Oh, come on, no. Don't let me fight the boss when I'm titchy-witchy. Titchy-witchy. Not gonna... Ooh, yes! Right. No! Yes! Maybe. Is the screen gonna keep scrolling? No, it isn't. But that was well needed, because I'm fighting this guy, whose name I can't remember, because... I'm bad at remembering the smaller Koopalings names, who are actually Bowser's children in this, but he denies all owning them in later games, like on the 3DS generation and the Wii U generation. He's a bad parent. That makes the wonder, does that... Is, like, the Koopalings, because I consider them Bowser's kids, we never know who Bowser's banging in this case. In this, like, sense. I mean, who did he do to knock up someone to produce 7 children?
And oh, thank heavens, I'm back to my old self again. Thank you very much, this is from the princess.
And I'm pretty sure that's the same thing as the last guy said, word for word.
Greetings, the faithful who stole the whistle has escaped to east side of the sand dunes. I have enclosed a jewel that helps protect you.
Okay. I think he's talking about a secret whistle, but I don't think I'll be showing that off. Oh, I love this level. It's one of my favourite, because this is one of my favourite worlds, because of what it does. I'll show you when we actually get there, which probably won't be in this episode, sadly. Oh, Chain Chomps. Another reason why I love them, I like Chain Chomps. Though I don't like what they did with the Chain Chomps' teeth in this. They're kind of, like, jagged. I mean, it's unique, but it kind of looks like... I don't know, it kind of... Back in, like, school, they had, like, this thing called... That they... Fuck you, cocksucker. They basically gave us, like, characters to remember alphabetical names back in primary school. And I remember one of my favourites, because it was the beginning of my actual name, Matt, or, well, Matelwash is my full English, my full name, but let's just go for Matt, because it's easier to pronounce. Basically, it started off with M, and the thing for that was Mighty Munch or something, which was like this metal-like monster, and I thought it, and it had like jagged teeth that stuck out either side of its mouth. A bit like Agumon from Digimon, but yeah, I don't really like that, it's kind of creepy, but at the same time, it does have its like a slight allure to it that I like as well, but it kind of puts me off at the same time, which makes absolute no sense. Tanuki time! A furry inside a furry... No, I said that wrong and could be interpreted for very wrong. A furry inside of a game playing a fursuit person. Furception. Yes. That works. No, I don't want that. And it's good I didn't jump for it. Ooh. I like the sound he makes when he jumps, though. It could be a little left, you cock munch. It could be a little less, you cock munch. I can't keep it. Why can't I keep it? Is it because I'm being too cocky and quick and confident? Doesn't sound like me, but then again, I do completely change when I click that record button. It's not like acting and putting something on. It's like I get overly confident when I click that record button. It's weird. It's basically like when I'm off camera, I tend to be off camera. When I'm off record captured device, I'm like, I'm actually quite depressive or... low self-esteem and all that, but as soon as I click that record button on my computer, I'm like, hell yeah, I am awesome! Goku hairstyle thing for Kami Kami Ha, or that big yellow thing. I never watched Dragon Ball Z, so I wouldn't know. But yeah, it's over 9,000! Confidence level. I just keep saying that, Let's Playing does ring up your confidence quite a lot. I mean, I noticed within my first year of Let's Playing, which actually was a couple of months now ago. Yay, Tanuki suit! Awesome! It does actually boost your confidence quite a bit. So I recommend it to, like, anyone with confidence problems, I guess, or confidence issues. Because I guess I kind of did have one. I guess I kind of do. But I recommend, like, trying to do a Let's Play, because it does ring up your confidence quite a bit. Even though nowadays it's kind of... like, really hard to get noticed as a Let's Player. It's still fun to do. Even if it's not for, like... Oh, can I whip you? Yes, I can! I wonder if the hitbox on that is bigger. I don't want that. I don't want to touch that, just in case it inverts me back to, Yeah, basically, even... Oh, no! I can't keep my Tanuki suit! Well, there's a better power on this level anyway that I want. Oh, fuck. It will be that shoe! Basically, these were shoes I think Princess Peach was talking about in the letter, and they allow you to do this. It's a jumping power, you're kind of crippled like you would be the frog suit, but I find it incredibly fun to do, and unfortunately, I've only found it in this level in the game. But it's insanely fun. I mean, you're inside a boot, it must stink, but... And it's a wind-up boot. Why are we in a wind-up boot? It makes no sense. But it's incredibly fun. I love this power-up. It's got to be in my top 10? 7? 7 Mario power-ups, maybe? I don't know what one. I mean, come on, it can jump on Petey Piranhas and get out unscathed. And the good thing about it, it is actually a power-up. So, okay, no, it doesn't stay out like after the level, but it stays out through pipes and that, which is kind of cool. And they give you a lot of opportunities in this level to... to, like, you know, get one. I think there's been, like, 3 right there, or 4. And unfortunately, you can't jump on those, like, mini plant things, which are annoying. You can't ever jump on them in any Barry game. I mean, in the Wii version, you could. They were, like, frozen, and they became unfrozen in one of the special levels. But I don't think you could refreeze them, which I found was a bit odd, because you got an ice power in that game, and you should have been able to refreeze them. Maybe you could, I'm just overlooking stuff. And looks like that's our use of the boot. Aww. I like the boot power, I want to take it with me. And Mario is luckily, like, keeping his nose out of the boot, so maybe it does smell. And I lost it. I love my boot powers. I'm losing so many powers that I love. Every power I love, I lose. Oh well. Next episode, I will be taking on this castle hither. So I'll see you then, Mega Nintendo Wolf, saying goodbye. I like this music, it's kind of cool. Bye.